To have your freedom in sandal making, you should know what possibilities do you have. Most of the sandals have straps. I divided all possible sandal straps on four types. And today, in this video, I will teach you how to make one of the most common elegant straps type with folding. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. If you want to make sandals, you need to know how to fold straps of the sandals, because most of the sandals will have straps. Now, you may have wide straps or narrow straps. In this shoemaking tutorial, I will show you the approach that you will need to use when you will work with straps that has minimum width of 8 millimeters and more. In the next video, I will show you how to work with straps that has width less than 8 millimeters. It will be a little bit different approach. But right now, let's learn how to fold straps of your sandals that has width of 8 millimeters and more. Why 8 millimeters? Why we start from 8 millimeters? Because we will need to reinforce the edges of the straps, and allowance that you need to add for folding is 4 millimeters. So when you will add to your strap that has width of 8 millimeters, 4 millimeters to each side, when you will fold, you will have enough space to attach these edges on the inner side of the strap, because 4 plus 4 will be 8, the total width of the strap that we want to create, that we want to fold. That's why there is one approach that you need to use working with straps that has minimum width of 8 millimeters, and this is approach that I will teach you today in this post, in this video. In the second video, I will teach you how to work with straps that will have width less than 8 millimeters. If you will want to make really narrow straps in your sandals, you will need to work with different approach. But right now, let's learn this approach that you can use working with straps that has width of 8 millimeters and more. 10, 9, 12, and so on. Here I designed this simple sandal that has straps, straps with the same width of 8 millimeters, but of course here can be sandal with wider straps here, and you can use same approach that I will teach you today in this video. So to make an upper for this strap, for these straps, just add 4 millimeters to each side of your strap and you will have the upper, because for folding we need to add 4 millimeters. Now you will need to skive your strap, leather strap, and to skive use marble plate. Now there is a small difference between folding of the straps and the simple upper, and you already learned how to fold the upper of your shoes, how to skive it. You can see the links for these tutorials below the description. Now, working with straps, especially with narrow straps, the straps that have width of 8 millimeters, you will need to skive one edge, then second edge, and then in the middle. Because when you will attach here reinforcement tapes, you will have here, you will add here to the width of your strap. And to not have too thick straps, you will need to skive in the middle as well. This is regarding narrow straps. If you will have straps with the width more than 8 millimeters, for example, starting from width of 10 millimeters, you will not need to scuff in the middle, because when you will attach heel reinforcement tapes from both sides, for example, let's say that here you have white strap, for example 10, so when you will at 10 millimeters, so when you will have when you will attach the reinforcement tape, you will have here distance of 2 millimeters between straps, so you will not here have here too thick strap. But after we will scuff the strap and when we will attach the reinforcement tape, we will have this situation in the middle. Of course, later I will show you, but just to explain you why you need to scuff in the middle, because we have here, we will add here thickness to the strap, and not to have some bump in the middle here, it's better to scuff in the middle as well, not only on the edges but in the middle as well. Okay, so we start to scuff. First, let's scuff this edge to hold here with the finger. Now you can hold here and scuff. You remember we need to scuff starting from one edge of the blade, and then we'll move it, this blade, along entire edge. I need to scuff here more to hold more comfortable this strap. So scuff along this edge, and you see how the strap change its shape. That's why it's very important to reduce to reinforce the straps as well with reinforcement tape, and to return to this shape of the strap, its original shape. Okay, it's happened because we use here force to scuff, and that's why we change the little bit the shape of the strap. Now let's scuff on the other side to hold here, and you see I need to scuff more. Okay, now I have enough space to hold it, and let's scuff from the other side. Now you see in the middle I have thickness of the original. I have the thickness that has this leather, and when I will fold it, I can feel it together with the straps, together with the tapes, reinforcement tapes that I will attach here. So that's why it's better to scuff the strap in the middle. Just hold the strap and scuff in the middle where you have this bump. You see, I always start scuff from this edge of the knife, and then I move this blade along the surface of the strap. Okay, that's it. Now it has even thickness, and after I will attach here reinforcement tape, it will be very thin, nothing very thin, it will be a strap with even thickness on entire strap. Now we need to attach reinforcement tape. I will not use here glue to attach this reinforcement tape because it doesn't have any curves, and it's very easy to work with straight straps, and it's enough to attach this reinforcement tape that has adhesive side without the glue. And now let's attach the reinforcement tape. From the distance of the edge, you need to have 4 millimeters. And I can see that here I used a little bit wider strap. It's not 8 millimeters. Let's check it. It's totally must be 16 millimeters, and I have more. Okay, I use here different pattern of the upper. You see it's 16 and it's smaller, bigger, so I will need to correct it. Okay, it's happened. Sometimes, so I will cut the strap to have the width that I need. 16 must be, and you see because it has it with curve, it change a little bit the shape. Cut a little bit the pattern. Never mind to fix it. If it happens with you, we need to attach masking tape to reinforce it in this place. Or make another one. So you see, now you will learn something new, how to reinforce, how to fix your pattern if you cut a small piece of the pattern. You can fix it with tape, or you can attach here. If it's difficult pattern, you need to attach here on cardboard in this place where you cut it and repeat the original line on the new attached piece of the cardboard. But if it some very tiny, very small piece that you cut, you can fix it also with the masking tape. Okay, now, so we have the desirable thickness, width of the strap, and now attach the reinforcement tape. It must be straight line and attach it in the distance of 4 millimeters from each edge of the strap. Now let's attach the reinforcement tape to the other side. And because we have here 8 millimeters width, the strip, the edges of the reinforcement tape must be attached close to each other. So attach it exactly to the edge of the reinforcement tape. So this reinforcement tape will guide you during folding. So now we will fold one side and then we will fold second side, and we will have very thin and beautiful strap. Now let's place glue to the strap. Let's place the contact glue on the entire surface of the strap. And wait until it will dry for for 10 or 15 minutes. After glue will dry, you can attach it. You can attach the edges. You can fold the edges. And there is a special hammer to fold this one. But if you don't have it, you can work with ordinary shoemaking hammer. It's a little bit heavier, but you can fold it as well. So now just attach the edge of the strap by following, fold the edge of the strap by following the edge of the tape, and that's why we need to have this reinforcement tape, because it will not only reinforce the strap in the upper when we will attach it to the upper, but it will fold, it will help you to fold your upper well, because you just need to fold the edge of the upper on the edge of the reinforcement tape. Now let's attach, let's fold the second side of the strap. And you saw that during skiving, the shape of this strap changed. And now you see, because of this reinforcement tape that we have, it has the original shape that we need. Now after you attach it, hammer it, and you see it has perfect 8 millimeter width. The strap has this desirable width that we need to have, and it's very nice and even strap without any bumps in the middle. That's why we needed to skive this strap in the middle. Use this approach working with narrow straps. It has width of 8 millimeters and more. If you will have wide straps, you don't need to skive in the middle, and you can use the approach that you already learned in the previous tutorials, where I taught you how to fold the top line of the upper. And if you want to work with narrow straps with minimum width of 8 millimeters, use this approach. Now in the next video, I will show you how to make very narrow straps that has width less than 8 millimeters, like 6, 7, or even 5 millimeters. It's very difficult to make, but you can do it as well using the approach that I will teach you in the next video. Right now, working with these narrow straps, you can use this approach, and then you just need to attach it to the lining and sew it, and you will have beautiful upper for your sandals. Okay, that's it. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Bye.